Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's your number one fan, Asian, and today is a very special day. EA have finally announced the World Cup expansion coming to FIFA 18. Woke up this morning and this was just plastered all over Twitter. So what I'm going to do in today's video is we're going to go over everything that has been announced, all the game modes, what's going to be happening in Ultimate Team. And since my channel is primarily career mode focused, most of the career mode stuff. Now, there was a trailer released. It was cute. It was basically like Ronaldo pulling out his, Portugal jersey, but it didn't reveal all too much about the various game modes that are coming to FIFA 18. So what we have done, we're on the website right here, and the website has given us a lot more information of what is to come. So let's go through that right now. Boom shakalaka. First thing you see right away, authentic 2018 FIFA World Cup Russia trademark experience. Feel the excitement and drama of football's greatest event with the authentic tournament experience through official FIFA World Cup trademark element. Featuring all 32 qualified national teams, match ball stadiums, and the iconic trophy rendered in Frostbite trademark game engine for the very first time. So immersive atmospheres, I'm not going to go through the immersive atmospheres in the Ultimate Team. What I want to do first is see all game modes right here. So let's go ahead and click on that. This is the good stuff right here. FIFA 18 World Cup update game modes posted April 30th as of 7 a.m. All right, so celebrate football's biggest tournament on May 29th. So it's about a month away with the FIFA 2018 World Cup Russia content update. The free content update contains new World Cup game modes, as well as refreshed versions of the FIFA modes you know and love. Whether you want to build your dream team, dream international squad, or play through the tournament with your favorite country, FIFA 18 World Cup is the perfect way for every gamer to play the World Cup. So that's the big thing, is a lot of people were speculating that maybe it could have been an expansion that, cost money, that you had to buy it, but no, it's going to be free, and it seems like we're going to get career modes alongside FUT. So for the career mode fanatics like myself, you can see right here, there's the 2018 FIFA World Cup Russia. Revel in the epic tournament exactly how it played out in real life. Choose from any of the 32 qualified nations tier for America, and play through authentic tournament structure from the group stage to the final in Moscow. So this is the default career mode. You select one of 32 teams that qualify and play it all the way through. Then there is the custom FIFA World Cup tournament, which I'm way more excited about. And this is your chance to rewrite history and enjoy a custom version of the World Cup with any country in FIFA 18. Select any licensed national team in FIFA 18, including Italy, USA, Netherlands, Chile, and more. And bring your FIFA World Cup dreams to life by creating your own tournament draw. And that is what I am super excited about. I definitely want to do some type of USA career mode. If I think China is licensed because they have the kits and that kind of stuff. It's just the national team isn't in there. I'd love to do a China Ruins the World Cup career mode on this channel. For you guys who aren't familiar, I'll leave a link to that. Let's continue on with the other game modes that they are featuring. So FIFA World Cup kickoff, jump into offline, match solo with friends using official teams, players, kits, and authentic atmospheres from the FIFA World Cup. So if you want to like play your friends offline, I guess that's cool. And then this is probably like the biggest draw to most people, and that is the FIFA World Cup Ultimate Team. Play FIFA's most popular mode in the new, exciting FIFA World Cup trademark, Ultimate Team Experience. That was a fucking mouthful. Build your dream international squads with stars from all 32 qualified nations, plus legendary FIFA World Cup icons. As you can see, Ronaldinho is right there alongside Ronaldo and Griezmann, the other. I guess like Griezmann's like a secondary cover athlete. But here, I guess this is the one that's going to get people wet who love Ultimate Team. All new icons. FIFA World Cup Ultimate Team will feature some of the most iconic players from the tournament's history. So does that mean we're gonna get new versions of icons like Ronaldinho, or are there just going to be like completely new icons? Like off the top of my head, there could be like Cafu, Beckham, that would just be like the dream people that would be in there. But you never know. Or they could kind of just be pulling a fast one, and then there's going to be, like a different version of the icon Ronaldinho. And then you can see the chemistry system. Link your favorite international players instead of clubs and leagues. Nationalities and confederations will be key chemistry components to consider when building and organizing your squad. FIFA World Cup Player Pool features up-to-date squads from every qualified nation with refreshed ratings. You'll have everything you need to build your international dream squad. Dynamic items built to match the real-world performance. These items will update based on the performance of players who stood out on match day and upgrade with upgraded stats, ensuring a fresh and relevant experience for the entire tournament. So, for you guys who are unfamiliar with FUT, they basically have cards that if they get like man of the match or, you know, a team of the week, they update. This seems to be even I guess like a more specific version of that, because it's going to go from a match to match basis. And then double pack incentive, and I think this is the big tell right here, is for every standard or premium pack you purchase in the FIFA World Cup Ultimate Team, I guess that's the mode, you will receive an equivalent pack of pack value in FIFA 18, which means it's going to be a completely separate Ultimate Team mode, just like they did 4 years ago in Brazil. For you guys who don't remember that, basically 4 years ago, they did pretty much this. I think it was the same exact game modes. They gave us like the World Cup, so you can play through the World Cup in career mode. You can create your own World Cup or recreate it in any way you would like. And then for Ultimate Team, there was basically a different game mode that you had to go into, and it also played differently as well. It was fun and refreshing because the gameplay was different, and also since the player pool is really, really shrunken down, which means that your odds of packing a better player is much higher. Pack odds, by that logic, should be a lot higher. You should be able to get at least like a couple of good hype players way more consistently than you would say with a monstrous player pool in regular FUT 18. And then you can see right here, Ultimate Team game modes experience several exciting ways to play through your international dream squad. Single player and online tournament, single player and online draft, and then squad builder challenges. All right, so looking over everything, there's honestly, I don't think there's that much difference from this year as opposed to 4 years ago. I think the only real new things is there's going to be icons. I don't think there were icons 4 years ago. Double pack incentive, I believe, is new. I remember 4 years ago when I was opening and busting open up some packs that it would occasionally give you a pack for the regular FUT mode. So that's nice. So there's only going to be online tournaments and there's only going to be draft. Seems a little bit dry. You know what I'm saying? SBCs is nice, but it doesn't seem like there's that much to really progress to. And there's no announcement on if there's going to be like weekend league or those types of tournaments for it. But I mean, they didn't say that it was going to be that way. So I guess keep your ear to the ground for you FUT guys to see if there's any more stuff coming out. Honestly, though, I'm a little bit, I'm not underwhelmed, but I'm not overwhelmed. This is pretty much what they gave us 4 years ago. I guess like my expectations were really low. So I'm not like disappointed or anything. This is actually a little bit more than I thought we would get. Like, in all honesty, I thought that they were just going to give us Ultimate Team, that they weren't even going to give us the career mode stuff. So for them to not only give us the authentic, you know, 32 qualified nations and play through with the authentic tournament structure and that kind of stuff, and then on top of that give us the ability to do a custom World Cup tournament, I think is great. So, you know, Italy, USA, Netherlands, Chile, those are, I'm pretty sure there are a lot of people who play FIFA in those markets. So it was really smart on them to allow you to rewrite history. Not that I'm bitter about it or anything, but nothing too exciting. I guess the biggest announcement is probably that there's going to be new icons. It would have been more hype if instead of Ronaldinho was on here, they showed like a Beckham or a Cafu or some World Cup god, you know what I'm saying? But I guess they got to keep a couple in their pocket. It's, you know, I'd give this a solid, you know, if I were to rate this announcement and what's coming in these game modes, I'd give it a solid B. As for myself, I'm not really, you know, a FUT-focused guy, but maybe, you know, what I'm interested in is, you know, it says that you can link up confederations. I might build myself an all-Asian team. But as for my channel, I mean, we're definitely going to do a playthrough of one of the nations. Unfortunately, China and the U.S. have not qualified. Put a bunch of countries in the eye thingies, the major countries that we could possibly go with, and we'll definitely do a playthrough of that with the authentic tournament mode. And then also on the channel, we'll definitely do a custom World Cup mode. If China is in there with their dope-ass new kits, you best believe I'm doing that shit. I don't care how shitty that Chinese team is. I'm getting that Chinese team in, and I'm gonna win this shit on Legendary. Mark my fucking words. If not, we'll do it with the US. Then we'll probably do it with both. So yeah, this is just like a quickie overview. Too long, didn't read. If you didn't want to like do all this stuff. Hopefully I gave you the right information, you know, all the sauce that you will need. Go ahead, get hyped. I mean, you know, my hype levels are pretty good. I'm just gonna keep it real with you. I'm not over the moon or anything, but I am happy. I am satisfied that we're getting the modes that we're getting. But yeah, that's pretty much gonna be it for me. Be modest. Hopefully you guys are having an amazing day. Leave it in the comments down below. Are you hyped for this game mode? Are you underwhelmed? Let me know. Speaking of World Cup glory, if you would like to go ahead and check out a series where I take Donald Trump and we try to make American soccer great again, go ahead and click up over here. If you want to check out one of my FIFA 18 experiments, then go ahead and click over here. Dings and booze. Anyway, that is it from me. Remember, stay yourself, stay humble, and until next time, guys, stay chubby.